put together, everyone said it. Before you left, I'd never felt a love like that.
I'm Kate Miller-Heidke and I'm at Birdland Studios recording my third album. You call my number, you call me just because. The record's going to be called Night Flight. It's named after one of the songs on the album, which is one of my favourite songs. I think there's a real thread going through this record, themes of darkness and light, and contrast and dynamics. We'll be the We've done this recording at Birdland Studios in Pran in Melbourne. It's run by Lindsay Gravina, who's the co-producer on this record as well. He's a bit of a Melbourne icon, and I really love the studio because it's come up here and time, the concept of time becomes meaningless. It's easy just to spend 12-hour, 13-hour days lost up here.
Comfort and pain and peace. You made me remember what it's like to feel something I don't think I'll ever forget again. 'Cause we got high.
Did you get it? I think you got so a lad, did you?
I got a lad, yeah.
Awesome.
So let's look to another for a double.
Yeah.
Cool, man. We just changed some of the settings.
I just had to get back to the setting of the snare.
So we're just going
to
do it again.
When we decided to do it here in Melbourne with Lindsay, I think there was a big freedom that came with that. The fact that we were in Australia and I could invite friends and musicians that I admire to come and be a part of it. Gives it a kind of a love and an energy that wouldn't be there if we just had to rope in strangers to sing on the record. And yeah, for the first time we had a few different drummers come in. We chose specific songs that would play to the strengths of different drummers. Steve Pope came in, who's my longtime drummer. John Castle, who's a friend of ours, amazing producer and drummer. And also Dan Parsons, amazing singer-songwriter. He approaches drumming from a real songwriting perspective. Yeah, I'm kind of in awe of him at the moment. We also had Kia's old friend from uni, Luke, come in and play the violin and the mandolin like a motherfucker, and he did the most incredible imitation of an orchestra with just a few viola parts and a few violin parts.
Change your mind.
Nicole Brophy, who I've been singing with for years in my band, she's got a great voice, really different to mine, but I love the way that our voices blend together. On the road, touring around the world, mainly as a duo. That's really affected my songwriting a lot, I think, you know, having played with a band for the whole course of the last record. And then to suddenly have everything stripped back, it was kind of a revelation. I guess, you know, when you play just as a duo, the main tool that you have to work with is silence and the space between the notes and the dynamics. And once you can harness that, I think just one voice and one guitar can be a really powerful thing. Perfectionist about it more so than anything else I've ever done. So we've basically just lived and breathed this record for most of the last year, and I can't wait for it to be finished, and I can't wait to release it into the world. We've spent enough time on it now. It's time to give it over.
Beautiful.
That was great. That was beautiful.